Would you please rise for the Carbondale Area Alma Mater and the National Anthem performed by Natalie Giordano, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
In northeastern Pennsylvania, sheltered in our wondrous vale, stands our noble alma mater in the town of Carbondale. Tell the story of our glory, sing her praises to the sky. Hail to their alma mater, Carbondale Area High. Oh, say can you see, by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave truth through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. Please be seated. Elizabeth Pantoja and Alexis Price will now share the history of the National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society.
In 1929, the National Association of Secondary School Principals turned its attention to middle-level schools and expanded its scope for recognizing outstanding students by establishing the National Junior Honor Society. With its own constitution, the National Junior Honor Society has established criteria that parallel the values found in the original organization and has likewise challenged its chapters to create enthusiasm for scholarship, to stimulate a desire to render service, to promote leadership, and to develop character in the students of secondary schools.
In 1921, the National Association of Secondary School Principals officially established the National Honor Society with the hope of creating an organization that would recognize and encourage academic achievement while developing other characteristics essential to citizens in a democracy. Though many local and regional honor societies existed prior to 1921, no nationwide organization had been founded. It was under the leadership of one man, Dr. Edward Reinerson, a high school principal in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, that the National Honor Society evolved from 1 to 1,000 chapters by 1930. Equipped with a constitution, an emblem and motto, and a group of dedicated principals as coordinators, the new National Honor Society quickly developed into one of the country's leading educational organizations.
Sophia Calzola and Josh Tierney will now share the values and significance of the National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society for students today.
The National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society remain the nation's premier organizations established to recognize outstanding high school and middle level students. More than just an honor roll, the National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society serve to honor those students who have demonstrated excellence in the areas of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. In addition, the National Junior Honor Society holds the quality of citizenship among its core values. While these characteristics have been associated with membership in the organizations since their beginnings in 1921 and 1929, they still maintain relevance in today's society. Now, nearly 100 years later, emphasis on these characteristics continue to make membership both an honor and a commitment for students.
Today, it is estimated that more than 1 million students participate in the activities of the National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society. Thousands of Honor Society chapters are found in all 50 states, the District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, many U.S. territories, and Canada. Chapter membership not only recognizes students for their accomplishments, but challenges them to develop further through active involvement in school activities and community service. Membership not only calls students to demonstrate academic achievement and leadership, but also to exhibit an honorable, admirable character that proves members are willing to use talents and skills for improvement of their society.
President Jonathan Purvis will now explain leadership.
Leadership. Leadership should exert a positive influence on the school. In taking the initiative in class and school activities, the real leader strives to train and aid others to attain the same objective. The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist, they are ineffective without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed, thus to lead is a substantive charge to each of our members.
Scholarship will be explained by Vice President Alyssa Coslow.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn even when formal education has ended, for education ends only with life. Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past and the light which illuminates the future. Candidates have the charge to continually expand their world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship.
Secretary Ellie Higdon will now discuss service. Service can be described in various ways. In the routine day's work, many opportunities arise to help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or without recognition is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow for our school, our community, and our world. Character will be explained by Chloe Rumford, filling in for Treasurer Emily Kelly.
Character. Character is the force within each individual which distinguishes that person from others. It gives a person individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character which guides one through life and, when once developed, grows steadily. Character must be achieved. It is the product of constant action and daily striving to make the right choice. The problem of character is the problem of self-control. We must be, in reality, what we wish to appear to others. By demonstrating such qualities as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, we may hope to prove by example that we value character.
Rosemarie Navarrete will now perform a musical selection. President Jonathan Purvis will now lead the members and inductees in the Pledge of the National Honor Society.
All members and inductees, please stand. Please raise your right hand. I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society.
To which I have been elected.
I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to Carbondale Area High School. And I will maintain and encourage high standards. Of scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Please be seated.
At this time, all National Junior Honor Society inductees and members will be inducted or recognized.
All seventh grade inductees, please rise. Seventh grade inductees are Macy Bognatz, please hold all applause until all names have been called. Cole Balderas, Reagan Bishop Russo, Aubrey Borowski, Riley Brennan, Sadie Brennan. Addison Calzola. Abigail Caracciola. Evan Serra. Liliana Serra. Olivia Consoretti. Clara Crandall. Lissa Durkin. Olivia Ellinger. Gabriella Granville. Taryn Gregory. Caroline Humpshire. Amethyst Kealoha Silva. Ava Mark. Martina McDonald. Kamara McGann. Diana Munoz Gonzalez. Alexis Novak. Stephen Oakley. Anna Pozwinski. Talia Perry. Alexandria Rosar. Xavier Rosar. Jada Salcido. Takoya Sanderson. Peyton Spall. Lily Thornton. Athena Tonkin. Maria Vargas. Caden Vaglino. Mackenzie Wallace. Ryan Waters. Congratulations, all seventh grade members. All eighth grade members and inductees, please rise. Eighth grade members and inductees are Ashley Arnice, Ella Casper, Taylor Corrigan, Xander Dombrowski, Julian Fedorchak, Ethan Gogren. Natalie Giordano. John Gorrell. Emily Grover. Olivia Lawler. Alexander Mackey. William Murphy. Albion Nasufi. Mason Nepa. Maureen Newcomb. Gianna Perry. Leslie Prieto. Matthew Sarkowski. Parker Smith. Delaney Strain. Zachary Tarchak. Madalena Zaccone. Congratulations, all eighth grade members. All ninth grade members and inductees, please rise. Ninth grade members and inductees are Ava Balderas, Alexis Black, Alyssa Bonk, Riley Brink, Caitlin Burns, Ariana Castaneda, Gianna Carlo, Eliana Connolly, Shelby Deck, Ian Dieslack, Stephen Ennis, Layla Esgro, Maggie Kane, Brianne Lucas, Sierra Martin, Hannah McCaffrey, Ethan McDonald, Alan Perry, Ava Peregrin. Angelica Prieto. Stephen Purcell. Logan Spall. Hong Tran. Abigail Wall. Thomas Wiggins. Summer Young. Congratulations, all ninth grade members.
Rosemarie Navarrete will now perform a musical selection.
Maybe it's all part of a plan.
All 10th grade members and inductees, please rise. Tenth grade members and inductees are Carla Augusto Rivera, Andrew Balderas, Casey Bannon, Jacob Berg, Kira Borowski, Caden Brennan, Jocelyn Brown, Preston Casey, Riley Colonna, Megan Coslow, Janessa Disla, Sadie Gardis, James Gelia, Madison Heenan, Erica Hollis, Kylie Kelly, Molly Kelly, Mason Milicheski, Emma Perry, Max Rossler, Natalie Skiba, Emily Tropiano, Zachary Staples, Robert Waters, Alasia Williams, congratulations, all 10th grade members. All 11th grade members and inductees, please rise. 11th grade members and inductees are Chase Arthur, Joshua Berg, Madeline Borders, Audrey Cobb, Gavin Connor, Robert Constantine, Shauna Durst, Gianna Gallo, Julia Gorrell, Corinne Haley. Bryson Kelly. Madison Kelsch. Gia Mark. Emma Monahan. Tyler Muskowski. Julia Murphy. Quentin Nara. Caitlin Ostrander. Elena Phillips. Brian Solitsky. Liam Shanice. Catherine Thornton. Matthew Totsky. Justin Toy. Jacob Ulmer. Congratulations, all 11th grade members.
Senior members and inductees of the National Honor Society will now receive their certificates. Senior members, please stand. President Jonathan Purvis. Vice President Alyssa Caso. Secretary Ellie Higdon. Treasurer Emily Kelly.
Mia Perry. Chloe Rumford. Rosemary Navarrete. Elizabeth Pantoja. Alexis Price. Joshua Tierney. Sophia Calzola. Logan Colonna. Franchelise De Jesus. Mackenzie Edgar. Tatiana Elston. Jaden Fedorchak. McKenna Fedorchak. Caleb Higdon. Deanna Holbert. Mia Marrero. Mackenzie Milicheski. Sarah Perry. Kyle Perry. McKenna Sanderson. Mackenzie Spade. Robert Wall. Kiefer Wies. Logan Warmoth. Congratulations, all 12th grade members.
Our acting principal, Mr. Gabriel, will now offer a few remarks.
To the parents and family members of these fine young ladies and gentlemen, thank you for emphasizing the value and importance of an education. Thank you for supporting and encouraging your children when they need you the most. Thank you for continually placing your trust in us and allowing us to be an integral part of your child's life. To our dedicated faculty and staff, thank you for the countless hours that you have invested into our students. Your passion for making a difference does not go unnoticed or unappreciated. Special thank you to our advisors, Mr. Carm Perry and Mrs. Alyssa Main, for organizing this event tonight. Also to Ms. Olivetti for her work with the programs, Mr. Schuster and Ms. McDermott for their audio and tech expertise, Mr. Scott Mahalik and the maintenance staff for setting up the auditorium this evening, Mr. Donnie McDonough and Mr. Joe O'Malley for their assistance in the technology department, Mrs. Mary Bucklaw for her assistance with the practices over the last few days, as well as our cafeteria staff for the refreshments that you'll be invited to partake in after the program. Tonight was an important evening. It was an opportunity for us to congratulate our students and their families on a job well done. Your achievements in the realms of scholarship, leadership, community service, and character were honored this evening by your induction into this extremely prestigious society. An honor such as this was our way of our school and community to recognize and celebrate the choices and sometimes the sacrifices that you all have made. We realize the road to success is not always easy. However, you have all demonstrated the perseverance and laser-sharp focus needed to achieve the academic goals that you have set for yourself. And for that, you should all be applauded. In order to maintain membership status, members must participate in community service and maintain a 90% academic average. The individuals that were seated on stage this evening and in front of me have committed themselves to these endeavors. I'm proud of the fact that these students have performed hundreds of hours of community service, as well as raised over $700 for a variety of good causes. On behalf of Superintendent Sayre, our Board of Education, as well as our faculty and staff, I again congratulate you for this tremendous honor, and you truly are the best of the best. Congratulations. We thank all of you for attending, and we invite you for refreshments in the cafeteria at the conclusion of our program.
All members, please stand.
Thank you.